What is going on, YouTube? It's your boy Stacks. We back at it again. We are here in week number 11. Let's go ahead and get into it. Best of luck to both of these teams here today. We got a great slate of games. A lot of people trying to clinch. A lot of teams, trying to keep their playoff hopes alive. And there's really one way to figure out who's going to make it to the playoffs, who out of the 12 teams will be the final six that will close out the season. And we got two teams here that are both looking to make an impact today. We will be in Dallas, Texas for this ball game. Clear skies for what I've been seeing. And it's going to be New Jersey at Dallas. Two teams on the opposite side of the spectrum. New Jersey playing from the east, Dallas playing from the west. And I can't wait to see this game. Both of these teams, they need the victory here so they can keep their playoff hopes alive. I'd probably say Dallas more than New Jersey, as I'm going to go ahead and look up the clinching setups here, just to see where everyone is. Dallas will still have a chance for the playoffs regardless, but New Jersey, actually the same thing for New Jersey. Both of these teams are still in play for the playoffs to at least get the 3 seed, maybe even a 2 seed. And looks like a loss here from New Jersey, along with the win by Toronto, will give the Toronto a playoff berth. And whether that be the 2 seed or 3 seed, that'll be dependent. So they don't need to win as Toronto. And on the other side, Dallas, they don't affect any playoff seeding because they're currently in the 5 seed, but they're still available to shake some things up. A big, big game here, and you already know how we do. The games keep rolling, so I'm gonna hit this play a game button, let it do its thing, and I'll be right back with some crazy stuff going on. I'll go ahead and flip over so you can get to the gameplay. It looks like Dallas will start us off, and I'll be back with you in just a little bit. Don't go anywhere. And a play like that'll put him smack dab in the red zone here, as DJ Church is lighting him up with the passing game. Dominic McKenzie had himself a solid run, and we'll have our first check-in into the red zone for this week, as Dallas is going to try to take the early lead here. They're going to go ahead and hand it off in a big hole again for McKenzie to get him down to the 10. And that's 2 carries over 7 yards so far for him. averaging 9 yards a carry. He's going to make a second and two coming. Sunny days here in Dallas, Texas. We're going to go ahead and hand it off again, pushing forward. There goes McKenzie inside the five, down to the three. Once again, staying with that 9 yards of carry setup. And it's first and goal coming up here for Dallas. They're looking really nice, if I do say so myself. Trying to punch it in here. New Jersey having trouble slowing down this all-around attack. DJ Church is going to pass out of this, looking for a man standing in the pocket, takes off to run, and he's trying to get the touchdown himself, who's going to reach over and push through the defense. There goes DJ Church, punching it in for the touchdown, and Dallas is going to strike first today, and what was an immaculate drive all the way around here for the Dragons. Can't be mad at that if you're a Dallas Dragons fan. Kick is going to be up. Kick is going to be good. And we'll kick this one off with a bang. Dallas with a strong drive there, over 70 yards. And they're going to punch it in for the touchdown. New Jersey coming onto the field next. Let's see what the big homies can do. And it looks like it's even deeper as Carson Cutbirth is going to get the INT over Ryan Bandy. And he's going to take it in for six. Dallas Dragons playing some inspired football today. Kick is up. Kick is good. First interception of the day there for Zaire Gustafson. Dallas Dragons coming through with a strong setup here today. They're playing for their football playoff rights. And up to this point, so far so good. New Jersey coming back for take number two.
Here we go. the kicker on for the extra point.
It's over, it's over, it's dominating! You Thank you.
Okay, looks like New Jersey's going for it. The onside kick, not gonna be recover there. And New Jersey is going to need a stop to give themselves one more chance. And Zachariah Branch has been lighting it up today. He was able to get that touchdown there. I've seen a few big plays while I was doing my thing. And here comes Dallas, one first down away from essentially closing this one up. They're going to hand this one off, and McKenzie's going to push test the 40. And that's going to make it second down in about three, maybe. He's had himself a solid day as well. Both offenses have been coming to play, and New Jersey's been fighting their way back into this game. They were down at least 17 points at one point in this game, and now they're only down three. And in the meantime, Dallas was still scoring, and we're going to see a handoff here, looking for the first to close it out. Arn brings him down, and that'll be ball game with this one. Dallas is going to take the victory. New Jersey, a valiant effort all the way around. Definitely GG's worthy in the chat. And we should see the kneel down to close this one out. Dallas still trying to keep their way in the playoff race. And DJ Church is going to walk away with the W after a couple of kneel downs. As we'll go ahead and transition into the setup here, where we do have the big homies. Let me see if I could bring it up for you. I lost my train of thought for a second. It's going to be another Western Conference matchup here so far this season, with St. Louis and Tacoma making their way into the mix. And it's an even bigger game now that Dallas got the victory, because if Tacoma loses, I'll put Dallas right back into the mix. St. Louis, they're going to look to try to get their second win of the season. And we'll go ahead and wrap this one up as we go ahead and flip back into it. Final score will be 34-31. No overtime needed. And let me go ahead and flip back over to it so you can see what's happening. It's going to be 367 yards to 334. Looking at the third down conversions, New Jersey struggled a little bit, under 40%. Dallas on the other side, almost at 70%, so a great job there. And Dallas did have the longer drives, 28 minutes worth of offense there, but both offenses were balling all game long. Azaire Augustus, 23 for 31, 318 yards, one interception. And you never know, that one interception could have been the difference to give Jersey the victory, because it was a pick six. DJ Church, 24 for 32, 271 yards, one TD. And the longest pass of the day is for 63 yards there by Zaire Augustus. Rushing wise, Dominic McKenzie, 20 for 87, averaging 4.3 per carry. Spider Webb, 8 for 34 and a TD. DJ Church, 3 for 1 yards and a TD. Joseph Eric Thompson, 2 for 19 and a TD. Up to no good, 2 for 12. Jordan Johnson, 1 for 3. Quentin Robin, 1 for 6. No fumbles on the game. No carries over 20 yards, and the longest goes to Joseph Eric Thompson there with a 16-yard gain. On the receiving side, Jerry Riggs leading the way, 8 catches, 117 yards, and a TD. Sir Lancelot, 5 for 35. Reginald Frome, 4 for 30. Can't speak. 4 for 57. Dominic McKenzie, 4 for 37. Billy Silly, 3 for 25. Looking at the drops here, looks like Riggs and McKenzie each had one apiece, and Reginald Frome had the longest catch of the day, therefore a 26-yarder. On the other side, the leading catcher will be Darren Guadiana, 8 for 71. Zachariah Branch, 6 for 189 yards and 2 TDs. A valiant effort there from the young wide receiver. Just couldn't quite get the W, but Vernon Mills helping out, 4 for 37. Spiderweb, 3 for 9. Ryan Bandy only had one catch, but it was a good one. It did get a touchdown. And up to no good, 1 for 10. I believe that was in the later portion of that game there. Guadiana had one drop, and Zachariah Branch had that longest catch of the day there for 63 yards. Defensive-wise, Arn Jacobson led the way with 12 total tackles. Jet Sosa there with 9, along with Everett Williams. David Sutherland with 8. Terrence Goldsberry with 7. Ethan McWells with 7. A.B. Johnson with 5. Matt Phillips with 4, Betsy Jenkins with 3, Lee Flowers with 2, LaDavius Button with 2, Lace Swan Grace Juan Carter with two, Rich Chattison with two, Matthias Sutherland with one, Dax Doherty with one, Tiger Band also with one. Jacobson and McWells each have a tackle for loss, and LaDavis Button had two sacks on the day. Good job from him. Pass deflection wise, Jacobson, Williams, and Phillips each had one apiece. No forced fumbles or anything like that. That's all the defensive stats for them. On the other side, the leading tackler will be John Fowler with 10 on the day, Wheezy Porter with 8, Rocky Ivan with 5, Joey Phillips with 5, TJ Blackman with 4, Jackson Storm with 3, Auden McKenzie with 3, Ethan Flowers with 3, Manuel Sun with 3, Chester Owens with 3, Billy Silly with 2, Dude Lebowski with 2, Quentin Robin with 1, Tank Tremonti with 1, Baron Wendt gets 1, Slug Stern, Carson Cutbirth, and I believe Jay Mangle got a pass deflection. We'll go ahead and double check that in a bit. With Wheezy Porter and Rocky Ivan each having a tackle for loss, Rocky Ivan leading the way with the 1.5 sack game. Great job there from the linebacker. Manuel Sun and TJ Blackman doing their thing with the sack, and Auden McKenzie split there with Rocky earlier. Carson Cutbirth getting himself a pick six in this ball game into victory. Can't be mad at that. 35 yards for the TD. Pass deflection wise, Jay Mangum, Rocky Ivan, Chester Owens, and Carson Cutbirth each had one apiece. No forced fumbles, and there is the touchdown there from Cutbirth, so make sure you put that in. All the good stuff. And starting with the kicking, Victor Crime 2-for-3 on the day for field goals, made all of his extra points, so that's going to be 10 points total there for Victor Crime. Assassin Moon, perfect on the day. Only one field goal there for 47 yards. And they both had one for 47 yards there. You see right there. And he's going to bring in 7 points total is for Assassin Moon. Punting wise, not a lot of punting today. But it did work out. Looks like it's 3 total punts on the whole game. And it's 57 on the average there for Crime on one punt. Assassin Moon averaged 51. Kick return wise, Jerry Riggs averaged 27 some change. Upton Ogood averaged 24 and some change. Punt return wise, Sir Lancelot, the only punt returner here, and he only averaged 5 on 2 attempts. Looking at the scoring summary, Dallas started out strong with the 17-point onslaught, and then New Jersey slowly worked their way back into it with the spiderweb touchdown. Joseph Eric Thompson matched that, and then Zachariah Branch matched that, and then Victor Crime matched that with the field goal to have it 27-14 at half. Then in the third quarter, New Jersey came through with another field goal. Dallas came through with the touchdown to Jerry Riggs. And then to close out the game, New Jersey, they fought their way back. Bandy and Branch each had a touchdown apiece, but they could not get the onside kick. Couldn't get the stop on the second down to stop the game. So we'll go ahead and set up here as we move towards going into the second game of the triple header. It's going to be St. Louis at Tacoma. And then we'll go ahead and wrap up the day with the big homies at, Toronto heading over to Arizona. A big, big game for both of these teams, and both of them have the ability to clinch. So make sure you show some love to them. Now that Toronto got the right away, a victory here against Arizona will lock in the Toronto Raiders into the playoffs, while Arizona still got to keep on fighting. So shout out to them. We'll see you all for the second game. As I mentioned, St. Louis at Tacoma will also be on YouTube, and we'll talk to you then.